This is Photosystem 1 and Photosystem 2 by Shane Mahoney,
Casey Kinsey,
and Brandy Samara.
Plants go through a process we all know as photosynthesis, which supplies us with our oxygen and our food. Where all this takes place is in the chloroplast, which is located on the leaves of the plants. Inside the chloroplast, photosynthesis is aided through the help of enzymes known as Photosystem 2 and Photosystem 1. Photosystem 2 basically oxidizes water and transfers electrons to Photosystem 1, where Photosystem 1 generates NADPH. Both Photosystem 2 and Photosystem 1 utilizes phosphorylation to generate ATP. Here we have a crystallized structure of the enzymes Photosystem 2 and Photosystem 1. Remember, the overall goal of both Photosystem 2 and Photosystem 1 is to help in the production of ATP. Next, we're going to go in full detail of both Photosystem 2 and Photosystem 1 individually with their mechanisms.
Okay. What we're looking at here is Photosystem 2 and Photosystem 1. So the mechanism first begins with Photosystem 2. I know it's called Photosystem 2 and this is called Photosystem 1, but the reason that it's called Photosystem 2 is because Photosystem 2 was actually discovered second. So that's the reason they call it Photosystem 2, because it was discovered second. All right, so let's get down to business. But right before we do, I just want to point out a couple things, little notes. Right here in the center of Photosystem 2, this is our reaction center. And within our reaction center, we have something called P680. Special thing about P680 is it absorbs light at 680 nanometers. So 680 nanometers, which is around red. So what it does is it absorbs red light. That's about the reaction center. But let's start with the very beginning. Basically, what will happen is a photon right here, will come down from light or any other energy source and hit Photosystem 2. Now what it does is it hits Photosystem 2, it's absorbed by the light harvesting complexes, and the light harvesting complexes bounce it from light harvesting complex to light harvesting complex until eventually it hits P680. So we have the photon hitting P680. What the P680 needs, though, is it needs an electron. So it gets this electron from this water molecule right here. So that's where it gets its electron. And the way that it gets its electron is it'll split up water. So it'll split up water into oxygen and hydrogen ions. So this one-half oxygen is just called one-half oxygen because it'll eventually join another oxygen molecule and become O2. So it'll become O2 later on. Anyways, this electron is taken from water and it moves up to P680. So we have the photon and the electron here, all inside P680. This now, the photon of course, excites this electron, and the electron then moves up in energy states into this electron acceptor up here. So it moves up in energy states. Once it moves up in energy states, you'll notice these arrows. This is called the electron transport chain. It'll move down this electron transport chain through these proteins to get to Photosystem 1. What this first protein is called is plastoquinone, but for short, I'll call it PQ. So PQ. So it'll travel down PQ. The electron then goes from PQ to B6F complex. Which is another complex, it's just another protein complex, it's just a cytochrome complex, sorry. And then it travels down to PC. So as this electron travels down the electron transport chain, you'll notice that these arrows are pointed in a downward fashion. So basically what this means is that the energy state actually gets lower and lower as the electron travels from protein to protein. So one of the things that happens during the electron transport chain is that this energy gets absorbed. This energy gets absorbed by this ATP. So that's what's happening. So the energy is lowering, that energy is absorbed by ATP, and ATP is then made, which is a very important process in photosynthesis. This B6F complex its whole job is to get the electron, link the electron from the photosystem 2 to the photosystem 1.
All right, now in photosystem 1, similar to photosystem 2, it is named this because it was discovered first in the process. And again, similar to photosystem 2, the photon is absorbed into the complex from an exterior source, which is more than likely the sun. This photon then bounces from light harvesting complex to light harvesting complex until it reaches the complex P700. P700 is named this because it absorbs light at 700 nanometers, and at that 700 nanometers is where red light is absorbed. But for the whole process, photosystem 1 and photosystem 2, all light colors are absorbed except for green, which is why plants give off the green color that they have. Now back to the process of the electron movement. The electron that moved from photosystem 2 to photosystem 1 is then excited by the energy produced by the photon that was absorbed in P700. And the electron moves up energy states into the reaction center located here. From here, the electron moves down the second electron transport chain into the complex here, which is called ferredoxin, which I will put FD for short. From this complex, NAD plus reductase then takes in the one electron, which I will fill in right here. But NAD plus reductase requires two hydrogen electrons in order to be complete. So the one electron that has already been absorbed by NAD plus left a blank space in P700, which needs to be filled. So the ongoing process of an electron from photosystem 1 moves back down the first electron transport chain, moves into P700, filling in this void area. The photon, same process, bounces from light harvesting complex to light harvesting complex and excites this electron, which jumps energy state up to the reaction center once again, just as the first electron. And then it moves down the second electron transport chain to the ferredoxin complex, where the NADP plus reductase then collects it and becomes into NADPH. NADPH and ATP then produce a sugar complex, which then produces a glucose molecule. And that is the purpose of photosystem 1 and photosystem 2.
Thank you for joining us in the discussion of photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. The end.